Good morning to everyone. Welcome to online classes. This is CH John Paul, lecturer English of Sri Venkateswara College of Arts and Science, Amalapuram, affiliated to Adikavinanna University, Rajamahendravaram. Now, I introduce to fourth semester syllabus. Once look at here, unit 1, soft skills. In this unit discussing underly, 5 topics are there, most important. One is positive attitude, another one is body language, and next SWOT or SWOT analysis, the next one emotional intelligence, the last one netiquette. These 5 units are underly discussing soft skills. And unit 2, paragraph writing, underly discussing 2 lessons. One is paragraph structure, another one is development of ideas. The unit 3, paraphrasing and summarizing, elements of effective paraphrasing, techniques of paraphrasing, what makes a good summary, stages of summarizing. And fourth unit, letter writing formal and informal. The next one is the e-correspondence. And last unit fifth, resume and CV, resume and curriculum vitae. The second one is cover letters. This is the syllabus of second year in fourth semester. Now we are discussing one by one, lesson wise. Now the first unit is soft skills. Soft skills. In the first lesson, positive attitude. Once here look at, it is very good thing. In the purpose of interview skills or any mannerism. So first of all, positive attitude, it means what is the attitude. This is very important. Attitude means, attitude is how one behaves towards somebody or something. It is one's personal view, opinion or judgment. It also describes one's general emotional approach towards a person or a situation. Simply said, that the attitude means your behavior. I think here one most important line is there. People have many opinions, but the deciding factor is one's attitude. The deciding factor is one's attitude. So in our life, the main role play our attitude. So discover the importance of attitude through this activity. One activity is there, observe here, and capital letters are there, A, B, C, D, like this. And is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like 26, up to 26. The value obtained after totaling the numbers against the words amounts their deciding factor in success. I think many of the people think like the hard work is the give 100% success. knowledge gives 100% success, like this, love and lucky, money, leadership or attitude, like this. But in our life, 100% success gives only our attitude. Once you have observed, is there. For example, hard work, which means number is 8 plus A 1 plus R 18 plus D 4 and W 23 plus O 15 plus K, sorry, O 15 SS, R 18, K 11. In total, 8 plus 1 plus 18 plus 4 plus 23 plus 15 plus 18 plus 11 is equal to 98%. Not gives the 100%. Not gives the 100%. So, and take another one, knowledge. So, same calculate. And 96%. And the next word is love, 54%. Luck, 47%. And money, 72%. The next one, leadership, 97%. But attitude is equal number to 100%. That is the importance of the attitude. So attitude decides altitude. Attitude decides altitude. Attitude is everything. Attitude is everything. People have different opinions about what leads one to success. The most important factor unabundantly is attitude. Attitude is the very, very important. And here observe the puzzler game. How do you feel when you face a problem? How do you feel when you face a problem? Have you ever faced a problem that you thought impossible to solve? Impossible to solve. You have noticed that winners have always faced problems badly. Can you recollect someone's victory that was the clear outcome of that person's positive attitude? Identify here. Try to remember the stories. Successful people who reached great heights because they were never frightened by difficulties. Now I explain one story. Now David and Goliath from the Old Testament, and pick up lessons from David. One story is I explain now. This is very, very interesting story because of David, man of positive attitude. David is man of positive attitude. David, a man of positive attitude, is an excerpt from the Old Testament. It describes the victory of David over Goliath. Who is Goliath? Who is David? The features of Goliath and David. Now I discuss it. The Philistines gathered their force for a war and assembled at Shoch and pitched camp between Shok and Azkaban valleys. The king Saul and the Israelites assembled and camped in the valley of Elah and drew up their battle line to meet the Philistines. The champion named Goliath, who was from Gath, came out of the Philistine camp. His height was about 9 feet 9 inches. 9 feet 9 inches. He are about 3 meters. It means in a battle between Philistines and Israel, this gaunt body, Goliath went on defying Israel's. The army of Israel was fighted and dismayed. David was a young shepherd boy. One day he came to the battlefield on his father's directions to give food and greet his elder brothers who were in the Israel army. David heard Goliath's insulting words addressing to the Israel soldiers. He felt humiliated. He asked one soldier there why they were not killing Goliath and tolerating the disgrace to Israel. He expressed his readiness to kill Goliath, readiness to kill Goliath. David's elder brother was angry with David and scolded him for coming over there. But David silently went to another soldier and asked some questions. David's words were reported to the king, who called David to him. David said he would kill Goliath. Wow. The king consciously asked about his lack of experience and the revival age, etc. But David politely said that he killed lions and wild boars to save their sheep. The king then happily and encouragingly offered his tunic and sword to David. David said he was not used to such things. He went ahead with his tough and sling. He ran towards Goliath. He just didn't care Goliath's fighting words. He said confidence was his sole weapon. He then took out a stone from his bag, put it in his sling, aimed at Goliath and threw the stone. Its train went to the forehead of Goliath. It sunk into his hand. He at once fell dead. David went there, climbed into Goliath's body and cut his head and declared his complete victory. The Philistines were terrified and ran away. Israel was triumphant and jubilant. David and his positive attitude were celebrated. Here I explained a good story. Some Telugu medium students can't understand, I think. I say in Telugu, David and Goliath, both are viriddaru Old Testament lo oka story teesukovadam jarigindi. ఇందులో డేవిడ్ గొలియాద్ని ఓడించిన ప్రాసెస్. యాక్చువల్గా గొలియాద్ ఫిలిప్సియన్ జాతీయుడు, ఇతను ఇంచుమించు ఒక 9 అంగుళాలు పెద్ద వ్యక్తి, హైటు వెయిట్. ఇజ్రాయెల్కి ఫిలిప్సియన్ జరుగుతున్న యుద్ధంలో ఈ హైట్ పాసం చూసి ఎవరు కూడా సోల్జర్స్ ముందుకు రావడం లేదు అతను ఓడించడానికి. ఒక ఎలా లోయలో స్టాండ్ అయ్యి అరుస్తున్నాడు నియర్లీ 3 డేస్ నుండి. ఎవరైనా మీకు దమ్ము ధైర్యం ఉంటే రండి అని, ఎవరు వెళ్ళడం లేదు. సైనికులంతా భయపడిపోయారు. డేవిడ్ యంగ్ షెఫర్డ్ బాయ్, గొర్రెలు కాచుకునేవాడు. ఇట్ ఏ స్మాల్ కిడ్, నియర్లీ 3 ఫీట్స్, ఒక 3 నుంచి 4 అడుగులు ఉండే ఒక చిన్న కుర్రోడు. వన్ డే ఫాదర్ సెడ్ టు డేవిడ్, వన్స్ గో విజిట్ టు యువర్ బ్రదర్స్, గివ్ ఫుడ్ లైక్ దిస్. చెప్పారు ఇంటికి కొంచెం వెళ్ళి మీ అన్నల దగ్గరికి వెళ్ళి భోజన పదార్థాలు అవి ఇచ్చారండి అని చెప్పడంతో వెళ్ళాడు. అక్కడ ఉన్న సిచ్యువేషన్ చూసి గొలియాద్ మాట్లాడే ఇన్సల్టింగ్ వర్డ్స్ ఆయన నచ్చక, ఈ ఫీల్ ఈ ఇన్సల్ట్ ఇన్ హీజ్ మైండ్ అండ్ ఇమీడియట్లీ ఐ రెడీ టు కిల్ గొలియాద్, నేను గొలియాద్ని చంపేస్తాను అనేటప్పటికి ఈ ఓడి మొత్తం మీద ఆ నోటి నోటి రాజుగారి దగ్గరికి చేరింది. ఆన్ దట్ టైం వాళ్ళ బ్రదర్స్ ఆయన్ని తిట్టారు ఎందుకు వచ్చారు ఏంటి అని. అక్కడి నుంచి గొలియాద్ని చంపేస్తారన్నది రాజుగారు, ఓడి కోసం వెయిటింగ్ చేస్తున్నారు ఎవరంటారు. ఈ అబ్జర్వ్ చేశాడు ఆ డేవిడ్లో ఉన్న సెల్ఫ్ కాన్ఫిడెన్స్ అండ్ ఫాస్ట్ విక్టరీస్, దీస్ ఆల్ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ రిమెంబర్డ్ అండ్ వెపన్స్ అన్నీ ఇచ్చారు. ఐ డోంట్ యూజ్ దిస్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ వెపన్, ఇవన్నీ నాకు అలవాట్లేదు, నాకు ఒక స్టిక్, ఒక వడిసేల సిల్క్, ఒక వడిసేల చాలని వెళ్ళాడు. ఒక రాడ్ తీసుకొట్టడం జరిగింది. గొలియాదును అవసరం తల్లి కింద పడడం, ఆయన తల నరకడం, అక్కడి నుంచి ఆయన వచ్చేయడం జరిగింది, గెలడం జరిగింది యుద్ధం. అంటే ఇంగ్లీష్లో మీకు క్లారిటీగా ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేశాను, తెలుగులో కొంచెం మీకు అర్థమవుతుందని ట్రాన్స్లేషన్ చేసి దర్శనం. ఓకే, నౌ యు ఆర్ కంపేర్ టు ది స్టోరీ అప్లయింగ్ అవర్స్, ఇట్ ఈస్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్. హియర్ ఆర్ సమ్ క్వాలిటీస్ ఆర్ ఐడెంటిఫైడ్. యూజువల్లీ అప్లయింగ్ ది స్టోరీ, యూజువల్లీ వీ లిమిట్ ద స్టోరీ ఆఫ్ డేవిడ్ అండ్ గోలియాత్ టు సైజ్ ఆఫ్ ది టూ మ్యాన్. హియర్ సైజ్ ఆఫ్ ది టూ మ్యాన్, గోలియాత్ వాజ్ హ్యూజ్ అండ్ స్ట్రాంగ్. గొలియాద్ వాజ్ హ్యూజ్ అండ్ స్ట్రాంగ్, డేవిడ్ వాజ్ స్మాల్ అండ్ కంపారిటివ్లీ వెరీ వీక్. ఇన్ దిస్ ఓన్లీ ఏ స్టోరీ అబౌట్ సైజ్ డిఫరెన్స్? నో, లెట్ అస్ డిరైవ్ సమ్ ప్రిన్సిపల్స్ ఆఫ్ పాజిటివ్ థింకింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ ది స్టోరీ. వై ఐ హ్యావ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ది స్టోరీ? Now we are observed in this story positive thinking. So the first quality in David or you and me, anyone, think positive thinking looks at self first. What is it? Positive thinking looks at self first. If you know the truth about yourself, nobody will fool you. This is remember in your life. If you know the truth about yourself, nobody will fool you. First, identifying yourself. What you are, what you have, what do you have? Think that. The Israel soldiers were looking at Goliath, not at their strength. That is the foolishness. The Israel soldiers, the good soldiers and best winners in many situations. But the Israel soldiers were looking at Goliath only, not at their strength. While others only saw the gained, only Sada gate. Oh, whose person? 9 feet, 9 feet, 9 feet, like this. A who's and strong, a who's and strong, like this thinking. But David kept his attention on the talent he had. Wow. This is the looks at self first. David kept his attention completely on the talent he had. On the talent he had. So that's why David forward to friend. So we are applying this point. Positive thinking looks at self first. The second one is positive thinking overcomes hurdles. It means one of a series of barriers to be jumped over in a race. That is the hurdles. Sorry, hurdles. When you start informing what is in your heart, you might face options, even from family members. David could have argued with his oldest brother. He had visited the place on his father's order. But even if David had succeeded the argument, he would have missed his chance to defeat enemy. Observe here one thing. David faced many insulting in this place. Because one said, the older brother scolded and argued with him. He had visited the place only on his father's order. But even if David had succeeded the argument, he would have missed his chance to defeat enemy. He never lose, he never misuse, he never lost. Never lost his opportunity. Don't move the back when you have faced troubles. So here are learned impossible things. Think positively to possible. Impossible things, think possible to think. Positive activity through possible. So the third one, positive thinking celebrates past victories. This is also very, very important. David began to recollect the victories of past shared with King Saul. Like this, if David was not faithful with the few sheep given him to keep on the backside of the desert, he would have never been able to stand up to Goliath. He shared all victories, past victories. The God helps to him in many times, in many trouble, incredible situations. And these all things recalled and shared with King Saul. So don't forget the past victories. Think about yourself. And the fourth one is, positive thinking is contagious. It means self-confidence. David's positive attitude and self-confidence convinced King Saul to permit him to go for a fight. That is the very, very important. He is not a soldier, he is not a training person, he is not how to do the battle, but he convinced King Saul to permit him to go to for fight. People may disgrace you in the beginning. Number of the person, even though own brothers are criticized, scolded, insulting, the surrounding people are disgracing. Don't stop on that place. The David not look at that type of words and not listen. If you persist, then they will support you. And how to fight the battle? That is what Saul did. He finally, the Saul asked to you, "Hello, mister, how did you do the battle? How to fight the battle?" Like this asking. Then immediately shared all these first victories. And the fifth one is, fear is enemy to positive thinking. Fear is enemy to positive thinking. Fear is enemy. So Goliath mocked David because he was only a youth. Ruddy and handsome is in appearance. David had to bear to the mark of his enemy Goliath. David's response was fearless. If you really believe in your strength, you won't run from a fight. You will run to it. You will run to it. You will run to it. If you really believe in your strength, you won't run from a fight. You will run to it. And the next one, positive thinking is a continuous process, is not a stopping process. This applying these qualities to in our life. Positive thinking is a continuous process. You have got to pursue your enemies until they cannot come back. If you read the whole story, you can observe that David chased his enemies until they were destroyed. They would never come back to fight him. And the next one is, positive thinking is result of empathy. When David arrives, he heard the taunts of Goliath. Positive thing is a result of empathy. When David arrives, he heard the taunt of Goliath. He was outraged and felt that was insult to his people. David was not a warrior, and he know it. Still he proceeded because he felt the need of power. The next one is, you may gather strength from background, but not all. You may gather strength from background, but not all. So David's background is included playing and singing songs. Under starry skies, writing poetry. And herding sheep. But he became a fearless and a violent warrior. David's faith became an action. Learned from his family and friends early in his life. This is the strong from background, but not all. He is a weak background, but he look at himself. Looks at self. And the next important point is positive thinking generates simple and creative solutions. David is neither a pessimist nor an optimist, but he was a realist. He looked his only staff, 5 smooth stones from brook, and marched towards the gate. He had his confidence in his talent of using his sling. And another quality, positive thinking opens the door of success and recognition. Very, very important. Positive thinking opens the door of success and recognition. Saul and the army Israel were shocked to see the impossible. They wonder how an unknown shepherd boy had defeated the giant. And later, he was offered kingship. This is the recognition. The last one is, positive thinking lets you stand specially negative world. Wow. Positive thinking lets you stand special in negative world. Good and bad things happen to all people in all positions and walks of life. This is 100% truth. However, importantly, a positive attitude allows you to see things which others do not see, and allows you to pursue where others stop trying. These are applying the qualities. Once remember these all things. First one, positive thinking looks at self first. Second, positive thinking overcome hardness. Third, positive thinking celebrates fast victories. Fourth, positive thinking is courteous. It means self-confidence. Fifth one, fear is enemy to positive thinking. Sixth one, positive thinking is a continuous process. Seventh one, positive thinking is a result of empathy. Eighth one, you may gather strength from background but not all. Ninth one, positive thinking generates simple and creative solutions. 10th one, positive thinking opens the doors of success and recognition. Last one, positive thinking lets you stand special in negative world. So this is the attitude of positive. In Learn from David and Goliath, I think ask some questions to you now. How did the Israelites get into trouble? The Israelites had to meet Philistines on a battleground. Goliath was a 9-foot-9-inch body against Philistine. He used to come out of his camp frequently. He would often address Reynolds from distance. He would challenge them to fight with him. Look at the 3 meters huge body of Gain. Israel soldiers were terrified and dismayed. The king was also worried. The fear of Goliath, the Gain body, and the absence of confidence in their friends led Israel into troubles. Who was Goliath? Who was in his personality? What is a challenge to Israel? I said to you already. And what is courage? Do you find courage in David? How? Yes. Courage is bravely in David. Takes breath in confidence. He grows up to a positive attitude. It results from looking at one's own strength. It generates from a comparative outlook. It also takes root in one's past victories. Yes, we find abundant courage in David. It was evident when he fought with lions and wild boars. It was visible when he spoke to the older soldiers. It was clear when he talked to the king. It was stringingly conspicuous when he faced Goliath. David was courageous because he had all the traits that produced the courage. Now, there are both positive and negative characteristics in this story. Identify them and say why they are so. I introduce 4 characters here in this story mainly. And positive and negative shade and reasons. Okay. The characters in this story, David, David's father, the king of Israel, it means Saul. The 4th one is David's brothers and soldiers. 4 characters are there. And their characters display the positive or negative and reason. David. David character is completely, the attitude is completely positive thinking. Completely. Positive thinking. Reason. He was a bold, confident, able, ready to take up challenges, willing to work for a good cause. This is the reasons. That's why David is a positive attitude person or man of David, man of positive attitude. And the second one, David's father. He is also positive thinker and positive attitude person. Why you said, I explain the reason. Old at patriotic, ready to sacrifice for the nation, eager to give, ability to help, faith in son's capacity. David's father sent 2 or 3 persons in army, work for the nation. He is a bold person. He ready to sacrifice for the nation. He eager to give, ability to help. Faith in son's capacity. This is the second character. The 2 characters are positive. And then another. The king of Israel name is Saul. Saul. His attitude also positive. Because of careful, cautious, ready to listen to, eager to encourage, appreciate others, abilities, etc. He accepted to all. That's why he is also a positive man. And the last one is David's brothers and soldiers. their attitude completely negative because they are timid persons, angry persons, try to avoid problems, prefer to escape rather than face. This is a main drawback. Is there always thinking negative, negative, negative? So, here are you have learned very interesting story and useful thinking. Because of applying ourselves, it is very, very important in our life. Thinking about positive thinking. The story of David does not just deal with the victory of a small man over a gained personality, but the highlights the importance of attitude that decides one's altitude. In the story, David was confident. Goliath was arrogant. In the story, David stood for good, Goliath of bad. In the story, David was for empathy, Goliath for terror. And in this story, David had power of mind and soul. Goliath had power of body. In the story, David overcome problems. Goliath creates problems. Thus, David was positive and Goliath was negative. Hence, the story is a symbol of victory of positive attitude. Clear? This is the very interesting and important applying story. And thank you. Next video continues to what is positive thinking and characteristics of positive thinking, like the formation of positive thinking, importance of positive thinking, advantages of positive thinking, how to develop the positive. These all things are discussed in next videos. Thank you. Utilize this class.